Today, I'm going to be showing you how to create a low-cost raised garden bed. I'm Danielle of Splitter Our Farm, and welcome to our channel, where we're showing you how we're turning our plot of land into a homestead, and every week we share two videos on how you can start farming and homesteading as well. But today, I am going to be showing you how you can create your own raised garden bed on a budget. And what does that exactly mean? Well, if you've looked across the web, you've probably seen that you can create your own raised garden beds out of wood, sheet metal, and we went to Home Depot and tried to get all the supplies that we could, and it came out to over $200 to make the garden bed that we wanted. So we knew that there had to be some other way. And that was when we found out that Home Depot actually sells stock tanks for $129 for the 2 foot by 2 foot by 6 foot. That means that it's 2 foot wide, 2 foot high, and 6 feet long. Now, we were really excited about this because this meant that we could actually grow two different rows of plants in this for our herbs and vegetables that we were going to be keeping right outside of our house. And today we're going to show you a few different ways that you can start to fill up those raised garden beds. Now, the first one is using the Hugelkultur method, and I'll put the name down there because I'm probably saying it wrong, but this is actually a method that was used by Germans in the past, and it really was showing that you can use a lot of your resources to make up some of the space in the raised garden bed. And what you're doing here is you're taking twigs, branches, you could even use stumps to fill out the bottom of the raised garden bed. Now, you're basically going to create a layer on the bottom, which we're going to start off with doing first. So let's get going.
Someone order logs. Got a ton of them.
We're going to now load up on some compost. I definitely suggest that if you guys are able to compost where you live, to do it, because it's going to save you some money and also create just a better planet being able to compost your own trash. Once you've created the Hugelkultur flooring, then we're going to start to layer in, like a lasagna, some layers of compost as well as soil. Now, we've been using worm compost for a while. You can check out some videos on how to actually start worm composting on your own, but it's super fun, and in the winter, it's a great way to get some farming in on the side. We're going to be mixing in some of these worms, some of the red wigglers and night crawlers, into our raised garden bed, as well as some peat moss soil, and then also some of our rabbit droppings, which we've been keeping for a while. Now, rabbit droppings are one of the best types of compost because you can actually use them right when the rabbits drop them. That is not common for many other droppings, so definitely make sure that you research any type of droppings that your animals are leaving, and if you can use them right away. I'm not sure about all animals, so you're definitely going to want to check that out. But let's start to add in some layers of that lasagna and get going. Now for the soil. So not everyone is gonna have compost. You can always purchase compost, and I will put some links below of some good compost. And you're also gonna want to have some good soil to add to that as well. And you're really gonna wanna just lasagna that in. Now, I have some seed starter mix here. These are about $1 to $2 each. I'm gonna mix these with some water, and then we're going to mix it around with the compost and start adding them to the bins. The final step is adding in your plants and letting your garden flourish. You guys enjoyed building our raised garden beds. I am going to include links of everything that we purchased below so that you guys can make these garden beds yourself. And please comment down how yours turned out. And we'd love to see some of your pictures. See you guys again next time. Bye.